I have also been asked sometimes, which do I consider to be the best of the Blasket books? I prefer to look at them from a different point of view. If we put them all together, side by side, we have a little library of 15 or 16 volumes, the Blasket Library. And this is something unique. There's no such collection in any other language. A collective portrait of a pre-capitalist village community made by the villagers themselves at the very moment of transition from speech to writing. Some of these books have been translated into English, and in that form they have circulated widely all over the world. Why have they attracted so much interest? What has happened to the Blasket Islands has happened, or is happening, to hundreds of other small communities of the same type in all parts of the world. The old village communities are being dissolved and merged into larger urban units, and their cultural values destroyed. The economic level of life in the Blasket was very low, but the cultural level was high. Economic growth does not necessarily bring with it an improvement in cultural life. Must it always be that the cultural standards suffer in the process of urbanization? In this way, these books raise questions in the reader's mind about the future of his own culture. I have compared the Blasket books with the Homeric poems. This may seem very far-fetched, but I am convinced from my own experience in the Blasket that the analogy is genuine. It's in the Blasket that I found the key to the Homeric question, so-called. What is the Homeric question? The question is, when, how, and by whom the Homeric poems, the Iliad and the Odyssey, were composed. If such a question is misconceived, we might as well ask, when, how, and by whom pigs' stories were composed. They weren't composed in our sense of the term. The Homeric poems were a mass of oral tradition inherited by a highly cultivated guild of minstrels dating from very early times and transmitted by oral tradition. And this craft was so well organized that it survived into the period of writing so that the distinctive features of oral poetry were carried over into writing. Well, this was a special combination of historical circumstances that made this possible. Similarly, in the Blasket, being so remote and inaccessible, the language and its traditions survived there exceptionally long. And for the same reason, scholars were attracted there who were interested in acquiring the language.